A man drinks suspicious coconut water for lunch. This is what happened to his brain. AC is a 39-year-old man presenting to the emergency room unconscious. Paramedics tell the admitting nurse that they found him in his house sweaty, nauseous, with pale skin, and laying down in a crooked position. Earlier that day, AC was living his regular life. He was hungry for some food, and when he looked, he found a sweet young coconut sitting on his kitchen counter. This coconut isn't like the hairy regular ones that you find in the produce section at the grocery. It's shaved and found in the refrigerated section. It's the one that you buy to get delicious coconut water from. The low temperature of the refrigeration helps limit microbial growth, and that's important because some bacteria and fungi enjoy and thrive on the natural juices of this fruit. But AC wasn't aware. He remembered that he had been seeing this particular coconut on his kitchen counter for at least the last month as he poked the pre-made hole in and started drinking. Immediately, as the coconut water touched his tongue, he knew something was wrong. The taste was so terrible that he spat it out, but not before he swallowed some of it. He noticed there was a smell coming from inside of the fruit. He tried cutting it open, and when he could finally look inside, he saw it was slimy and rotten as he showed it to his wife and threw it away. He kept rinsing out his mouth because the taste lingering inside was so awful, but he was sure that he completely washed it all out. As the hours passed, AC started feeling funny. At first, he noticed that he was sweating, but the room wasn't really that hot. He felt his palms were kind of damp, maybe a little clammy. In the bathroom now, AC could feel a tinge in his cheeks as a sour taste rushed into his mouth from under his tongue, and he emptied his stomach into the toilet in a way like never before. Unsure of what was happening, he looked in the mirror and noticed that his complexion was a pale gray color. But the image that he saw in the mirror was starting to not make sense. As he stumbles out of the bathroom, he loses his balance. On the floor now, in a crooked position, not knowing where he was, not knowing what was happening, he was able to summon enough strength to call for 911. In the ambulance, paramedics noticed that AC could still respond to questions, but it took him some time before he could speak his response. But as he's brought to the emergency room, AC becomes unresponsive. At examination, doctors found that AC's heart was still beating, but his blood pressure was high. When they shined a light into his eyes, his pupils could still react and constrict. All of this meaning that at least one part of his brain was still functioning for now. A blood test finds that AC has metabolic acidosis. Acid in this context being a waste product of metabolism or cellular activity, but more formally known as the concentration of hydrogen ions in his blood, and osis meaning a disorder of excess acid due to cell activity. But which cells are doing this? The medical team notices that AC's forearms and his calves would randomly jerk. Given that he was found by paramedics in a twisted and crooked position, there could be something wrong with his muscles, but the nervous system controls the muscles, so which one has the problem? In the intensive care unit, AC's body temperature is now higher than when he presented to the emergency room. If he has acid in his blood because of abnormal metabolic activity, he quickly became unconscious in the ambulance. His muscles are twitching randomly, and he now has a fever. Then this could mean that AC has an infection that's somehow affecting his brain called meningitis. Itis meaning an inflammation of the meninges, layers of membranes surrounding the brain and the metabolic activity, causing acidosis might be from a problem with his cells in reaction to the fact that bacteria is now growing in his nerves and his brain. But how can the medical team be sure that this is what's happening? Doctors send a needle into his back to collect cerebrospinal fluid to test. If bacteria is infecting his brain, this fluid should give some clues that something is growing inside, but time is quickly running out. The medical team doesn't know for sure if he has an infection. They start him on antibiotics in hopes that if this is an infection, some of the bacteria can start to be handled immediately. What doctors also don't know about is the suspicious coconut water that AC drank. He couldn't tell them about it because he was unconscious. His wife told doctors that AC had showed her a rotten coconut just hours before she found him crooked and sweaty on the floor. This gives doctors some clues as to what's happening because as the labs return for their cerebrospinal fluid, it looks like there isn't any infection in AC's brain at all. When a fruit becomes rotten, it's anyone's guess as to what kind of bacteria and fungus were growing and thriving inside. In medical literature, rotten coconuts and corn have been associated with Bongkrekic acid, a mitochondrial toxin that's made by Burkholderia bacteria, which sometimes appears as a result of incomplete fermentation. This gives us a couple of clues. First is that a rotten coconut that's slimy on the inside likely has bacteria and other microbes growing in it. If AC consumed part of rotten fruit, and that particular fruit had microbes growing in it, and those microbes can produce mitochondrial toxins, and the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell but can't be because a toxin is preventing it from performing cellular metabolism, resulting in AC's metabolic acidosis, then all of this should make sense. Except when the coconut was tested, the lab couldn't find any Burkholderia bacteria. They tried multiple different tests and even tried to look for Bongkrekic acid itself, but none of it was found. An MRI of AC's brain reveals that fluid has been swelling into his brain, particularly in the parts that control movement, learning, and memory. A blood test finds that he has hyperammonemia. Hyper meaning high, ammone referring to ammonia, a chemical made as a result of the body breaking down proteins, and emia meaning presence in blood. High ammonia, presence in blood. Proteins are large compared to simple molecules. They're long chains of simple chemicals so the body can chop them down to digest and handle them. Gut bacteria do that digestion. Each chain link in any protein are called amino acids. Amino referring to the chemical group amine, which contains nitrogen. Life on Earth all require nitrogen. It's why you hear about needing nitrogen in the soil with fertilizer. And from an ecosystem perspective, the exoskeleton on some bugs contains chitin, which is a significant container of nitrogen. If nitrogen is the essential part of amino acids, which is what proteins are made of, and the body needs to break down those proteins to get the nitrogen in order to function, then it makes sense as to why our bodies normally make ammonia, because that's the simplest nitrogen compound that can exist. But it also makes sense as to why AC has hyperammonemia. The liver requires a lot of energy to function. If AC somehow ingested a mitochondrial toxin from suspicious, rotten coconut water, it could prevent his liver cells from producing the energy needed to handle ammonia flowing in from his gut. AC's brain, also an organ needing lots of energy to function, was already impaired because of the toxin, but as extra ammonia starts floating around in his blood because his liver has shut down, it gets into the brain. It causes fluid to start to swell in, meaning as AC's brain starts shutting down, his liver shutting down makes it even worse. But it's not his only problem. The same blood test finds that parts of AC's muscles have broken off and started spilling into his blood, likely because his brain had trouble controlling the contraction and relaxation of his muscles. And because muscle tissue is also energy dependent, this should make sense. Those muscle remnants collect in his kidneys and rip apart the tubules, causing his kidneys to shut down too. The medical team notes AC doesn't have meningitis. He doesn't appear to have any bacterial infection. The rotten coconut from where he took a sip of the suspicious water also didn't have the Burkholderia bacteria that would make the Bongkrekic acid mitochondrial toxin that could cause all of his problems. But given that his brain is swelling with fluid, his liver has shut down and allowed ammonia to spill everywhere in his blood, parts of his muscles have sloughed off and are now floating around in his blood, causing his kidneys to shut down. What else could have been in that coconut? In the lab, further examination of that coconut finds the presence of the fungus Arthrinium saccharicola, known to produce the toxin 3-nitropropionic acid. In the mitochondria, this toxin is shaped like a chemical that's normally used to help produce ATP for energy. When the toxin is present, instead of the mitochondria using the normal chemical, the 3-nitropropionic acid slides in and prevents energy production. As cells of the brain, especially in the areas that control movement, start to panic and run out of energy, some of those cells start to die. Muscles can't be controlled properly anymore, and they don't have sufficient energy to function as they start to float around in the blood. The liver cells also start to die quickly, and ammonia can't be handled anymore, causing the brain to swell even more. All of this happening because AC unfortunately drank suspicious water from a rotten coconut that had mold growing in it. 24 hours after AC presented to the emergency room, a scan of his brain showed severe swelling. because the brain is enclosed inside a hard space, the skull. There's only a limited amount of space for it to swell before it starts to crush up against the sides of the skull and ooze through the sutures or the cracks in the skull. And on the scan, it looks like this brain herniation was impending. AC's pupils no longer responded to light. Reflexes that would show that his brainstem still conducted and communicated signals in his body were no longer intact. AC could no longer breathe for himself, and at 26 hours after admission, the medical team needed to make a decision with his wife whether or not to continue treatment. When it comes to food, especially fresh produce, fruits, and vegetables, it's important to keep them fresh. If they need to be refrigerated, refrigerate them. Be cautious with expiration dates. That's not to say go overboard and throw away everything in sight because you heard of one video online talking about someone getting catastrophically ill from drinking suspicious coconut water. But if something looks weird, if something smells weird, something tastes weird, just be careful. Sometimes it isn't even the bacteria or the fungus growing on the food that can cause problems, but the fact that those microbes could produce chemicals that are toxic to humans, that is what can cause some issues. It's not common, and sometimes accidents happen, and relatively exotic things, like drinking from a coconut, can lead to mistakes, just like in AC's case. At autopsy, bleeding was found in AC's brain. Re-examination of the coconut and a sample of his blood found the 3-nitropropionic acid mitochondrial toxin that was responsible for everything that happened to him. This toxin was something made by the Arthrinium saccharicola fungus that was found in the rotten coconut from which AC had a drink of this suspicious water. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.